Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles. Sorry, I turned away then. Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. And sorry, I just had something in the way. And we've got another of the Durham Brewery, a St. Cuthbert. Is it Cuthbert? Yeah, a St. Cuthbert. They're at 6.5. Now, I don't really know a lot about what to expect here. It's an IPA, and that is about all I'm being told, apart from that it's live, there's probably sediment and blah blah and everything else. Wait a minute, let's see if I can do one of my tricks. One more, ready? Click, click. Yeah. Right, click it open, tell them stop messing around with your barfly. Do you know, people probably think I'm getting paid to keep messing about and mention the barfly and that. Yeah, they sent one down, they sent a couple down. But I can stop talking about it if I want to, I don't have to talk about it. But you know what? When you get something that is quality, that's the only trouble. You have to show it that way instead of that way. I want to show it off that way. It's upside down. But when you get something that's quality, I want to shout from the rooftops about it. Because I feel, you know, I ain't saying I am, but I feel I represent the people. And I kind of, if I think something's crap, I'll tell you it's crap. And if I think it's good, like this is really good. The quality behind this is unbelievable. And yet it's still a little toy. It's a man toy. You know, you don't feel like you're a little kid playing with little pink toys and things, but it's still a man toy that you can kind of mess around with and that. And as well as being a man toy, it's just everything about it is so cleverly designed and engineered as being a good, really good tool. You know, like if you've been a worker on a site or anything, or done any sort of job, draftsman's job or anything like that, where you use different tools, you pride yourself in a good tool, you know, in really excuse me in really good tools. So if you find a really good tool, you want to sing its praises. You want to, you know. Anyway, up we go. And with the old beep, shiny top, I think you got it. A shiny cap there, crown. There's debate about whether call it caps, crowns, tops, whatever. I think the proper technical term is crown. Most people call it a bottle cap. Some call it bottle top. Do I care? It keeps the beer in. If it keeps it fresh, does its job. It's quite an old thing, quite an old design, you know, the old bottle cap. Nowadays, some of them are going for the screw tops and things like that. I think screw tops is a better idea, but it's not tradition, you know, so there you go. But I do like the idea of a screw top. Anyway, I'm going to get me snozz on this. It smells really clean and not a lot else going on. Really clean. It almost smells kind of like a clean, kind of like one of them lagers, sherbet-y kind of lagers, isn't it? Let me see if I can get something. Just getting out of the way because I had something in that glass before it. I'm getting something off the flavour anyway. but I'm going to do it in the right order. You see, people have asked me, do I, when I'm drinking one just usually, you know, do I sit there and kind of swirl it and kind of mess around and sniff it? No. Because apart from if you're in the company of like the Canberra festivals or the GBBF or whatever, you know, you can get away with that a little bit. But if you're in a pub and you start going, and all this business, you look like a bit of a nana in a pub doing things like that. So what I do, I go, I put it to my lips and sniff just as if I'm having a drink. And you get a sniff then. Yeah? So I'm having a sip. I'm not getting a lot off the nose there. Really not. Almost a slight antiseptic on the nose. So, the Durham Brewery, what I've found of it so far, have been pretty good. So let's have a taste. Oh, that's nice. Yep. You got what I believe to be a Fuggles bitterness at the back there. Maybe even a Challenger in there as well. But nice, you know, nicely mixed together. Am I a little bit high or using? I'll tell you what, let's lower the seat a bit. I always think I'm going, hey, look, that's it, I'm right on the floor now. No, we are a bit high, ain't we? I go like that now, and all you see is the fluff on the top of my head. Look like a plucked chicken, don't I? Yeah, there's a kind of like a Fuggles in there. Almost a North Down bitterness in the back of the tongue. Yeah, possibly a Challenger. And usually with them you kind of usually get a Goldings. There seems like there may be a Goldings, an East Kent Goldings there. When you're getting light malting, you got a little bit of sugarness off of, I would imagine, a Crystal Malt. And you've also, it would seem, a Maris Otter or something like that. That's as far as the malts go. Listen, if you're out there trying and tasting different beers, don't worry if you're not getting any of the hops, because most of the time we're wrong as well, you know. We're just kind of guessing at them, you know, and most of the time we're wrong. You know, it's not an applied science. Pardon me. But a lot of the time what you get is you'll get reminded of different flavours. You'll get certain things. You'll get a combination of the hops and different malts together, and suddenly you'll go, good Lord, I can taste blackberries, I can taste, yeah, you really do. And I can taste oranges and grapefruit. There's none of that in it, you know. There's no oranges, no grapefruits, no, none of that. It's just a combination of different malts put in at different times in the brew. You know, you can put them in early, you can put them in late, you can get the malts. I mean, the malts are pretty much what you're talking with the malts. Yeah, there's wheat and stuff like that, but pretty much what you're getting is barley. And it's a barley field. Yeah, there's kind of different row barley and all that business and different... but practically, you've got kind of one ingredient there, and then what they do is get that and then toast it up the same way coffee beans are toasted up to make different flavours. You toast it up to a certain level, chocolate. A bit further, coffee. You know, a bit less sugary things. If you kind of stew it just in a little bit of wet juice, because what they do is they put it in water to start with to get it to germinate. As it germinates, enzymes inside turn them starches and carbohydrates and whatever into sugars, and sugars are fermentable. They're what the yeast like. They're lovely. But there's sugars with the flavours of the barley and everything else. They've still got those flavours. So when they turn into alcohol, the alcohol has still got those flavours as well, carrying him along. That's why when you've got inverts, or when you've got like sugar, refined sugar thrown into something, it tastes of refined sugar thrown into something. And these companies that do that, some reasons are kind of bona fide. If you've got like, you need something kick-starting to get a real hot IAB, ABV, and things like that. There's lots of technicalities and things like that, but some companies just put rubbish and kind of, you know, put in maize and, you know, maize, corn flakes. It's about all it's good for. It's not good for beer. Sugar, adding sugar to something. That was done during the war. You know, that when barley malts and that was hard to get hold of, so they just top it up with sugar. You know, it's not done anymore, you know. Well, it is by some companies, and it is for bona fide reasons. But if your recipes, your bona fide recipes, those recipes from old, and it was delicious, if they've been changed and added sugar to, or added colourings, first things first, the notes that have got to go off in your head. If you get a beer that's suddenly got colourings added to it, has suddenly got E numbers added to it and stuff like that, and you look and it says colourings, why are they suddenly adding colourings? What's happened to the beer? What has happened with the, you know, adding maize or corn to the beer that has made it need colourings to kind of set a smoke screen up? You know, what's happened to that beer? You've got to ask yourself these questions. Read the ingredients on beers. Most of them, most of the premium beers anyway, are pucker, you know, but there are some that are doing the wrong thing. They're doing nasty things with the beers and that. They're putting E numbers and shit in that is only kind of belongs in Coca-Colas and Pepsi-Colas and all that sort of stuff. There's sort of colourings and stuff. So, stop it. It's me back again. Right, this is me running out of time, as usual. Only some Cuthbert, 6.5. Very, very nice. So, buy one and try one. I kind of like the Durham Brewery. It's not fantastic, in my opinion, but it's still pretty nice. All of their beers that I've tried have been pretty good. What I call, like, yeah, thumbs up, pretty good beers. But I'm not kind of waving me, you know, throwing me hat in the air and all that. Anyway, before I run out of time, this has been me ranting on again. Terry K for Beer Goggles Reviews. Thank you very much for sticking with me. Bye.